Nigel here from Team Ascend, and I'm coming to you from Hidden Valley Raceway in Darwin. And I thought I'd take this opportunity to run you through some of the action-packed days that we've had in leading up to setting up here at Hidden Valley. Before the team arrived and after my arrival to Darwin, we were allowed to go to the Northern Territory Transport Association and get the car approved for on-road testing. And this is something that we were looking forward to doing and something that we were hoping would be quite easy because of all the preparation that we put into the car. So we took the car out of the trailer after its long trip up here to Darwin and presented it to the Northern Territory Transport Association, who looked over the car and were happy enough to give it the tick of approval for on-road testing, which I'll get to in a minute in this video. The next day the team arrived and they came in quite late in the afternoon, acclimatised themselves to the Darwin heat, and then the very next morning we had a media opportunity and an activation down at the Darwin waterfront, which was put on by the Bridgestone World Solar Challenge. And this was a school holiday activity that gave people an opportunity to get up close and personal with both our car and other team members' cars, which was a really great opportunity to introduce the team members to Darwin and also have a look around the beautiful city. After we loaded the car back up from the Darwin waterfront, we were able to come here to Hidden Valley, which will be our home for the next couple of weeks. And this is the site where we use our garage to prepare our car, we use the racetrack to test our car, and we're able to meet all of the amazing teams that have come here from all around the world. So we got pit garage number 25 set up right here, got all of our tools and everything in order, and then started work on the car, making sure that it was all prepared for testing. One very important aspect of the Bridgestone World Solar Challenge is safety. And with so much going on and so many teams and so many people here, we had to run through an induction to make sure that we were all understanding the protocol that we need to adhere to here at the raceway. And this took us through an afternoon of speaking to the marshals, the track coordinators, and getting the rundown on everything that we can and can't do here at Hidden Valley. Once that induction was done, our team got to work on all of the little things that they were thinking about while the car was getting shipped up here to Darwin. So we had a few items on the agenda to fix. One has been the solar, which we really haven't concentrated on too much down south because our test days really haven't involved that much sun. But now it's time, now that we're here in Darwin, to then get all of this working. So this involved making a pre-charge unit for the MPPTs, and then the mechanical guys could go over the car and make sure that it was all set up and ready for testing. Our three drivers are up here early as well. We have more of the team arriving a little later, which we're all looking forward to reuniting with. But our three drivers involve Angus, we have Bowen, and also Taj. And Taj has been doing some extra training, and he actually ran a lap of this circuit and set the quickest time, which we're hoping that other teams will try and challenge. But what it is really good to see is that Taj is acclimatizing to this heat. It's now 35 degrees at 9 a.m. in the morning, and also getting ready for the long stints of driving that are ahead in possibly even hotter conditions. Speaking of hot conditions, we took this opportunity to use our now approved car and to take it out to the pre-event testing site, which is just north, about 10 minutes from the track here. And this allowed us to use some on-road testing, which has been approved by the Bridgestone World Solar Challenge. And we were there on the first morning along with other teams to test our car. So we had our three drivers, Angus, Bowen and Taj, all jump in the car and get a feel for what on-road driving will be like here in the Northern Territory. So it was really good for the car to touch down on the red soil for the very first time here in Northern Territory and get an idea for the temperatures and how it's going to cope through all of the testing that we're looking to do prior to the actual challenge, which will start very soon. One of the biggest things was cabin temperature for us and also motor temperatures, and I think this first test session we came away from it really happy and really pleased with all of the preparation that we did to the car, keeping in mind that where we're testing is some 15 degrees cooler than where we're going to be competing in here in Darwin. So we hadn't had these temperatures to test in, and we were really worried about how the motor and the battery and the whole system would last up here in these temperatures. But we're happy to say that cabin temperatures stayed around 40 degrees and the actual motor temperatures weren't that much more than that and stabilized quite quickly, which was really good to see. Our ventilation into the cabin worked well as well, with our drivers giving us great feedback on how the car was to drive. And it was stable. There was a few trucks out there as well, which the guys had to contend with. And we used a range of speeds and then looked at the data after this to make sure that our car will make the distance once we start the challenge. And if it won't, then we've got time now to be able to make a few tweaks, do more testing and figure out ways that we can improve the car at this stage. But we're really happy and we're really stoked that all of the work that we've done leading up to this point has given us a car that we don't have to do too much work on right now. And we can just spend our time checking out all the other teams, meeting all these great people here at the Bridgestone World Solar Challenge and settling into our home in Darwin. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll update you on all of the stuff that's happening here. We're now allowed to do on-track testing, so in our next video we'll cover a bit of that. But yeah, we're just stoked to be here and opening our account for the Bridgestone World Solar Challenge to come.